Hi, I'm Amy Ford, and I'm going to teach you all the basics for accounting for property, plant, and equipment, commonly referred to simply as PP&E. How accountants depreciate PP&E is another important topic, and one that can be confusing for introductory accounting students. We will walk through all the basics together, including some calculation examples. Property, plant, and equipment represent long-term assets. These assets benefit more than one accounting period and are therefore capitalized and recorded as assets on the balance sheet. The category PP&E includes the tangible long-term assets. When a company acquires PP&E, all the costs necessary to bring the asset to its condition and location necessary for its intended use should be capitalized. Okay, so what does that mean? In addition to the cost of the asset, if the company incurs shipping, delivery, setup, installation, and/or testing costs to get the asset ready for its use, then those costs are included in the cost of the asset. Let's go through an example of this concept together. On March 1st, 2017, we purchase a new machine with a cost of $40,000. We also pay $1,000 for shipping costs and a $2,000 installation fee. When purchasing PP&E, we capitalize all the costs necessary to get the asset ready for its intended use. In this example, that means we capitalize the shipping and installation, which makes the total cost of the asset $43,000. To record the acquisition, we debit the equipment asset account to capitalize this new asset. Now, what about costs related to the asset that happen after the initial acquisition? This is an important topic. Costs that maintain the asset, such as ordinary repairs and maintenance, should be expensed as incurred. For example, when you purchase a car, you'll have to maintain the car with routine maintenance, such as regular oil changes. These oil changes are simply maintaining the asset and reoccur frequently throughout the life of the asset. These costs are expensed in the period incurred. On the other hand, some costs after acquisition should be capitalized. That means these costs will be added to the long-term asset. Costs that extend the life of the asset or increase the productivity of the asset should be capitalized. These are significant investments in the property, plant, and equipment. Going back to our car example, perhaps your 6-year-old car with 130,000 miles on it could last another few years or like another 100,000 miles if you replaced the transmission. The cost of the new transmission would be capitalized. Here's an example of a CPA exam type question that tests your knowledge of the concept that we just discussed. During the year, Murdoch Company made the following expenditures relating to plant, machinery, and equipment. Renovation to a group of machines at a cost of $100,000 to secure greater efficiency in production over their remaining 5-year useful lives. Continuing, frequent, and low cost repairs at a cost of $70,000. Replacement of a broken gear on a machine at a cost of $10,000. Here's the question. What total amount should be charged to repairs and maintenance for the current year? The first item in the list, the $100,000 renovation, should be capitalized. That amount will not be expensed or charged to repairs and maintenance in the current period. The other two items maintain the assets and would be expensed as repairs and maintenance, so the answer is $80,000. Is what we've covered so far giving you a better understanding of property, plant, and equipment? I really hope this video has helped. If you want to learn more about how to record these transactions, as well as how to calculate depreciation using the straight line and double declining balance methods, then click the link below or go to glime.com and look for our free basic accounting course in the CPA free resources section. In the course, you'll find other great information on topics such as the details on how to record inventory and liabilities, which can really help you in your financial accounting classes. So click below or go to glime.com to learn more.